Right. So he says, but I can explain the Mishnah. It's talking about something very thin, just a pin, just a needle. So, you know, I just lob that very carefully right on top of there. And therefore, it's not taking up any space. So it's not going into the airspace above. It's just, you know, I'm just throwing it right up there. And it doesn't come from Mekom Patur. And we answered, no, that doesn't work. No, it's impossible that it doesn't take up any space at all. If the table, if this post is exactly 10 tefachim, then it's going to take up some space and it's going to be above that. And then before it lands, it's going to be in Mekom Patur. Okay, so another answer. Or maybe it has a little something sticking out over here, like over here. Right, if it's sticking out that way, that it's technically part of the post, so it is a shute achid, but this happens to be below, and so I can throw it onto here, and then it never went into the airspace, and then that would be totally fine. Or maybe there's a groove on top, and so I can just throw it, you know, right into the groove without going high up, and that way. We resolve that problem. Okay, so that's how they answer him, right? But, you know, if really the Mishnah is only talking about that, then, in fact, if you threw it higher, then he would be right. It would be a makom patur. Okay.
So we've undone the actual statements of the Mishnah?
Almost.
Can I place something on top of it?
Well, that, according to him, they say, what about you? What do you think? What do you do with the Mishnah? So this is really only the Mordechai interprets the Mishnah that way, right? They would say the Mishnah is as is, but they don't really explain the situation of what about if you throw it. I think that if you place it, or if you're walking and you place it, then certainly it would be chayav, because walking, right? So even if you're carrying something high, it's still considered carrying because it goes by your feet. It's connected to you. And so if you're walking and you place it, even though it comes from high up, then still it would be chayav. And that's actually, the Mishnah is only talking about, Mishnah says, hanotel or noten. It's talking about placing. It's not talking about throwing, right? So placing would be chayav. Throwing is, then a little bit more complicated. Perhaps throwing would be patur. But the rest of the rabbis all, the question was about throwing. Well, the next question, but they're throwing, and they all said chayav. They assumed it was the same. Okay, Amar Rav Mayasha, Ba'ayi Rabbi Yochanan. Rabbi Yochanan has a few questions. Kotel b'rishut harabim gavo asara ve'no rachab arba'a u'mukaf lecharmelit v'asao reshut hayachid v'zarak v'nach al gabav mahu. So I have a wall. It's in the middle of the Reshut HaRabim. It's 10 tefachim high. Okay, that's good. But it's thinner than 4. So in other words, therefore, it's not a Reshut HaYachid, right? It's nothing. And it surrounds an area that's a karmelit. It surrounds something that's like a farm or a desert where people do not pass through. And by surrounding it, because it's 10 tefachim high, it is considered a barrier. It's a wall. And so it turns the karmelit into a reshut hayachid. Basically, it makes an eruv area. And then I take something from outside, reshut harabim, and I throw it on the wall, on this enclosing wall, and it lands on the wall. What would be the law? Mi amrinan, kevan de nora havar ba mekom patur hu, o dilma, kevan da asa'o reshut hayachid, keman de midle damya. Do I say that since the wall is thinner than 4 amot, it's makom patur? So I did nothing. I just threw it onto there, and it's as if it didn't land, and it did not land in the shut hayachid, so I'm okay. Or do you say that because it encloses the shut hayachid, it encloses the karmelit and makes it a shut hayachid, then it also becomes part of the shut hayachid. Even though it's thinner than 4 amot, it becomes part of it. Amarula, Kalvachomed Lacherim, Osemechitzala, small local shaken, Kalvachomed, yes, it's going to be Chayav. If this wall makes the part inside into a Reshut HaYachid, then all the more so, it itself must be Reshut HaYachid. התמנמה, אמר רבי חייא, אמר אשה, אמר רב, וכן אמר רבי יצחק, אמר רבי יוחנן, כותל ברשות הרבים, גבוה 10, ואינו רחב 4, מוקב לחלמלית, ועשהו רשות היחיד, הזורק ונח על גביו, חייב. לאחרים עושים מחיצה, לשמאל לא כל שכן, because we have a statement of Rabbi Rav and Rabbi Yechi Yochanan, this is exactly the same thing, that the wall around becomes part of the Shuta Yechid itself, and therefore throwing on top of the wall, although it's a thin wall, is part of it. Okay, that was, so we were able to resolve one question. The rest of the questions are going to be more complicated. By Rabbi Yochanan, Bor Tisha'a, Ba'akar Menu Chulya, Bishlima La'asara, Mahu. Okay, listen to this fantastic case. I have a pit that's only 9 tefachim. So 9 tefachim means it's part of a shuta rabim. It doesn't have any status. It's just removing from it, if I just move it a little, then that would be totally fine. So now I take a shovel and I dig in this 9 tefachim, and now I make it deeper by digging. I make it 10. And so now it's 10, right? So when I started the act, it was only 9, so it would have been okay. But when I finished the act, now it is 10. So what's the law? Akirat chefetz vasiyat mechitza b'hadeh ka'atu mechayev. Do I say that removing that extra dirt and creating the extended wall, making a tent of achim, happen at the same time, and therefore it would be chayev because it happens at the same time? As I lift the dirt, then it's already 10 tefachim deep. So then I lifted and I transferred. Or do I say, no, it doesn't happen at the same time. As I'm lifting, it's not a board. Only after I finished, then it becomes a board. And therefore, patur. That's the two sides. Im timse lomad, and if you say, kevan de lahave mechitza asara meikara, lamechayev, if I say, in that case, since when I started off, it was not 10 tefachim, and only became tefachim afterwards, and so therefore patur. What about a more next case? Bor asara benatan letocha chulya umiata. I had a pit that was tefachim deep. I took a shovel with dirt from outside of the pit and I put it in, and now I made it less than tefachim. Mahu hanachat acheves besiluk mechisa ba'de adadeka atu michayev. Do I say that as it lands? It's landing comes at the same time as it becoming not a board anymore, and so therefore chayav because still it landed at the time when it was ten tevachim or lo mechayev, or do you say not that it doesn't land in a board because it fills it up already? I think the difference between these two cases is that in the first one, as I'm kind of transferring out, it was not a board until I finished. Whereas in this case, I took dirt from outside, and as I'm transferring in, it is a board. And so it starts off as a board, so it probably takes a little bit more effort to undo it than to create it. So these are left unanswered, but perhaps we can draw an analogy. Tifshot lemedideh titnan. We can learn it from what Rabbi Yochanan himself says regarding another Mishnah. Hazorek arba amot bakotel lemada ma'aser tevachim kozorek ba'avir lemata ma'asera kezorek ba'aretz ve'hazorek ba'aretz arba amot chayav. That's what the Mishnah says. Mishnah says if I take something and I throw it on a wall, if it lands above 10 tefachim, then it's like airspace, it's nothing. If it lands below 10 tefachim, then it's like it lands on the floor. And if I throw something for amot in the shuta rabim, hayav, right? I don't have to carry it and walk it, even just throwing it. We have a question regarding if it lands on the wall, it didn't come to a rest. It didn't land. And so assuming that it bounces off, right? If I throw a ball, playing a handball, even if I throw it, but it's going to come back. So it never came to a rest. Bouncing is not resting. He said he's talking about a fig cake, like a fruit roll-up. It's really sticky, and I throw it on the wall, and it sticks on the wall. And so therefore, it landed. So if it sticks on the wall below 10 tevachim, then that's the landing. That's what Rabbi Yochanan said. And now, look at this. Hold on, let's say I'm standing exactly 4 amot from the wall. And I throw the sticky fruit roll up, and it sticks down on the bottom. at this point, it becomes part of the wall. And when it becomes part of the wall, now the wall is a little bit closer to me. Got that? And so now I never threw 4 amot because it didn't make it all the way, because now the wall is actually closer. And so you see here is a case where, although this is similar to filling up, taking dirt and filling up a board that was 10 tefachim and now it's a little less. And in this case, he says, chayav. So too, in filling up a board, it should also say chayav when it goes from 10 down to 9. In other words, the filling up happens a split second before. You need some calculus for this, right? As the distance approaches zero, what exactly happens? So no, we reject that analogy. Hatam lemevatele, hacham mevatele. In that case of the fig cake, when it attaches to the wall, it doesn't really become part of the wall. I'm not nullifying it in my mind. I'm going to go and take it off. I'm not going to leave it there, right? Whereas when I'm filling up the pit with dirt, I'm intending to leave it there. Now it's going to be a filled-in pit. And so, therefore, that case is not the same. And so Rabbi Yochanan's questions are left unanswered. Okay, further questions that we're not going to answer. Ba'ay Rava. Zarak daf venach al gabe yetedot mahu maikami ba'ale hanachat chavis vasiat mechisa ba'de'adea ka'atau hainu d'Rabbi Yochanan. Okay, here's the case. I have 4 sticks that are in the ground in the shu terabim, in the middle of the street. Okay, only 4 sticks. So these 4 sticks are thin. And so therefore, since they're thin, they don't count as anything. But here's what I do. I take a board and I place it or throw it onto the sticks. And so when I place it on there, what happens? Now it becomes 4 tefachim by 4 tefachim. Now it becomes a little table, and therefore it's a reshut hayachid. But here's the problem. Now this board, did I carry the board or not? Right? So by placing it or throwing it onto the 4 sticks, right, is that considered carrying? It's only carrying if it's a reshut hayachid. But it's only a reshut hayachid once it lands. So at the moment it lands, in a way, it becomes a reshut hayachid. And then, am I carrying and by placing it onto the reshut hayachid? Does it happen at the same time or not? So we say, that's the same as the Rabbi Yochanan. Rabbi Yochanan already asked that question. It's the same thing as, right, if you create a reshut hayachid by removing a tefach of dirt, and then you're creating it at the same time as you're moving it. Isn't that the same? Oh no, he's asking something different. What if I'm throwing a board and as there's something on it? There's something on the board. This is, I don't know, this looks like an apple pie or something, right? And so it's on the board, and I take this pie with the board and I throw it directly onto the 4 posts. And so now, kemai kevan de behadehadadekatu, since they're landing at the same time, is it that they happen at the same time? Both the board and the pie together all land at the same time, and therefore patur, because it was not a reshut hayachid until it landed, and after it landed, so it was already there. Or it's impossible that when, as it lands, the board lands slightly before the pie comes down onto it, and so therefore it would be chayav, because, right, the board lands and then the pie lands on it after, so therefore I'm chayav for throwing the pie onto something that was already the reshut hayachid. Okay, so we need a little physics for this, right? So actually it's not so complicated according to physics. If I was standing here and I threw it up in an arc, right? I threw it up in an arc and then it came down just by gravity. Then according to physics, they would stick together, right? The pie, the board and the pie would fall at exactly the same rate. Even if the board was heavier, it doesn't matter what it's made out of, the rate of gravity would be exactly the same. And especially if there is air resistance, it would actually push up against the board, and so they would stick together. So in that case, if I'm throwing it in an arc, it would be the first one, they would stick together. However, if I'm directly on top and I throw it down, So then, in that case, the board would be have more acceleration than the pi, and the board would land first, and then the pi afterwards, in which case, surely, that would be hayav. Okay, we'll end here. We had a lot of fun and interesting theoretical cases, and you can just imagine the students of Rabbi Yochanan and Ava back then, right, arguing both each side of these fascinating cases to get at the particulars and details of these very important and practical principles that apply to creating a Reshut HaYachid within the Reshut HaRabim. Okay, thank you, everybody.